RTE Radio 1 traffic and travel with the Hyundai i10. Ireland's best-selling city car 4 years in a row. Get to know Hyundai at hyundai.ie.
The latest travel news from the AA. To Galway, it's slow inbound on the Tuam Road from Two Mile Ditch to Bonar Drab. Busy approaching Briar Hill and Munavay Road and on Bonar Drab itself. And delays on the Dublin Road from GMIT to Renmore.
A decision by An Bord Pleanála on the future of the Galway Ring Road project, which was due in April, has now been pushed back to the end of June. This project, which began over 20 years ago, has been delayed by legal challenges from environmentalists, forcing a complete replanning of the route. To understand why the proposed Ring Road is so important, it is crucial to know a little about the history and geography of Galway City.
Historically, Galway is a medieval town with narrow streets built hundreds of years ago. These streets were not designed for modern vehicles. Geographically, Galway is bisected from north to south by the River Corrib, and all east-west traffic must cross one of four bridges.
Only the newest of these four bridges is designed with modern traffic in mind. These bridges, combined with medieval streets and poor planning, mean the dedicated lanes for public transport are largely impassable within the city centre. If we want people to move away from cars, a reliable and efficient bus service is vital. However, a lack of a dedicated bus corridor within the heart of the city makes this impossible.
Data from the last census of Ireland shows that Galway has about average pedestrian and car usage. Still, the underutilization of bicycles and public transport is also evidenced, despite introducing a public bike scheme in 2014.
This data suggests the city's travelers don't see a benefit in choosing public transport compared to other Irish cities. They instead find themselves in hour-long traffic jams at peak times. Poor planning, including zoning decisions that prioritized residential development in the west of the city and industrial development in the east of the city, are a leading cause of increased daily cross-city traffic.
The Galway Ring Road would aim to ease the commute times for those travelling from one suburb of the city to another, while prioritising public transport use in the city centre.
Critics, however, suggest that this road will only attract further development along its route. A study by Arup shows that just 3% of traffic would use the road to bypass the city, with the majority of traffic utilizing it as a distributed road. If this happens, there is a risk of ending up in the same position as currently exists. Even if the Ring Road gets approved, it's unlikely to be built for many years. Further actions are needed to remediate the current traffic issues. Some of these include several park and ride spots should be added in prominent suburbs, utilizing the city's bus service to filter commute traffic away from the city center. Some two-way streets within the city could be converted into one-way systems. This would allow for a dedicated bus corridor that would significantly improve efficiency and confidence in the bus service. A congestion charge for non-commercial drivers should be considered, as in London and other cities. Traffic volume can be controlled within the city centre with a charge for peak time travel through the city. The introduction of safe cycling routes around the city would encourage commuters to transition from cars to greener modes of transport. Until then, all Galway motorists can do is grin and pray.